Welcome to the Dr. Renee Sunday Show, where it's not too late to shine. We bring you transformative information for small business owners, entrepreneurial insight, wisdom, and secrets to aid you to be seen, be heard, and get paid, to catapult your life to more impact, success, and freedom. Now, please welcome your host, the platform builder herself, Dr. Renee Sunday.
Hey, everybody, we're here. This is Dr. Renee Sunday herself. We're so happy to be here. If it's morning, afternoon, wherever you are right now, your office, your car, if you look at home, we are here. And the key is to give you education awareness that we actually can make a wise decision. Like we just said, it's not too late to shine. So we actually love, we thank you for this opportunity. We thank you for supporting us in the things that we do. But we're going to talk about the three secret hacks to have a profitable podcast interview. To tell you a little bit about myself, you know I am the platform builder. So what I do is I help people identify their purpose if they're not aware. And then what we also do, we make sure we increase your visibility to be seen, be heard, get paid. Small business owner, office, culture, speakers. Because the thing is, we have a lot of content, we have a lot of information, but are we actually hearing the ching ching? Okay? Is it profitable? Are we success? Are we actually impacting other people's lives? And that's a question we need to meditate on because you know the answer to that. And we have to be realistic. The things that we're doing, what are we really doing? As some people say, is it a hobby? You know, because IRS will let you know, right, if it's a hobby. But we need to actually get the information that we can actually help people, impact people, but guess what? Also make sure that we have profit, that we can actually help others, that we actually can also put back in our business as well. So one major thing that I love to do is tell people that they have to be seen. You have to be on television. You have to be on social media. You have to write for magazines. You have to be on podcasts. You have to speak. You have to speak at different events, different organizations. You have to do this. You have to be seen. You have to be heard. So what are you really saying when you're speaking? Are you giving value? Are you giving information that people can actually use it right now, that people can actually impact others, that people can use to take their problem away? I always say so people can have peace, joy, and love, because that's a real underlying problem that we have, that we want to feel that we belong, right? So all of those need to be in place that you have that influence. We hear about influencers, especially on Instagram. But you listen to what they have to say. So when you actually have an ad with an influencer, you assume that they believe in that product, that they believe in that brand that they actually are supporting, right? So you want people to like, trust. And then actually people need to be able to, you know, they say like, trust, and then but you actually have to have people to make an action. A lot of people, unfortunately, want something for nothing. And my mom and dad always said, whatever you have in life, you have to work for it. And you actually value things more when you actually pay for them. And if they're too cheap, meaning, you know, low price, a lot of times people don't take it seriously. Right, that is true. You would think that people will be privileged, that they'll be honored, that they actually be able to get some complimentary, that they actually get something that they don't have to pay at this time, that they can get some information that they actually can apply to their life to go to the next level. But realistically, people don't. We don't. Yes, yes, yes. So also what I also do, we have a publishing company, so I always tell you about having a market-winning book. A market-winning book is a book that you can use as a business card because, you know, we don't use business cards as much now, right? People use media kits, EPK and all those kind of things. But your book will speak for you with an amazing cover, but, of course, having valuable information in there as well, right? Mm-hmm. But anyway, we're going to get to the subject. The subject is three secret hacks to have a profitable podcast interview. The first thing I want to talk about is make sure, you know, this is coming from a person that interviews people, and also I have been interviewed. You know, my portfolio, I've been interviewed on, you know, a lot of the major networks here in Atlanta and also in D.C. And I've been on the platforms of Oprah Winfrey, Bishop T.D. Jakes. We're part of the NFL in regards to broadcasting with the Good Deeds radio and TV show and Dr. Renee Sunday podcast and show. But the thing about it is we need to realize, one, are we right in the right niche? If you're talking about how to groom pets, animals, are you on a shelf about sports? So you ask the number one, you need to make sure you are researching and contacting the right type of podcast. As you know, I do have a media contact list that you actually can to grab and grab and grab and use that information. But please have your ducks in a row. You have to be able to research the different outlets and know what the show is about, know what their mission is about, their mission statement, what type of format they have, is it pre-recorded, is it live, how long it is, what they stand for, what other shows they've had. You have to know that. I get so many people that want to be on our platform, and they'll ask us what we need to do. Well, if you went to our site, you'll know that our show is 30 minutes. You'll know that I am the host. You'll know the things that I stand for. You'll know the different things that I do in my business. And you'll know how you align with that or you don't. So do your due diligence. That's number one, of contacting the right niche. And, you know, they say niche, avatar, of course, but who do you speak to? Mine is mostly women entrepreneurs, small business owners, authors, coaches, speakers, right? And then also I have learned of the people that's purchasing my products that the millennials, maybe 19 to 27, that they actually love me as well in regards, because I guess I'm a mother figure, you know, I'm nurturing, that they actually can trust what I say. You see what I'm saying? So they actually purchase my products and services. So you need to know that. You need to know where they, you know, what, how much money they weigh, they make. You need to know what type of what they like, what type of magazines they like. You need to actually know what shows they like, because you use this information in marketing. You use this information in regards of if you're going to do a Facebook ad, Instagram ad, those type of ads. All of that is part of that targeting. So you need to know your target work market, okay? And then you have to continue to work on that. When you actually have found the podcast that you want to be a part of, you need to contact them. And you know I have Swipe File, and it's available, and I'll tell you about our master class that's coming up. And at the time of this recording coming up, but actually you probably can take advantage of that if this is after the date of that master class, the podcast master class, that you can take advantage of that and you can get that information on the media list, you can get the Swipe Files, those type of things, of knowing what to say and guess what not to say on a podcast. And even when you contacted them for an interview, because some people would get a no because they, the host, the producer, feel that you're not aligned actually with, guess what, with their brand. You see what I'm saying? And people love to be on NBC, the top brands, but they want to know that you can handle an interview, that you know what to say and what not to say on an interview. So a lot of times they wait, and they want to know how many interviews you've had already. A lot of times they want you to at least have 100 before you can actually be on a major platform. So the first thing, yes, that's what's heavy, heavy, heavy for number one. The number one, you need to do your due diligence in regard of what your research is. Everyone wants to have the light camera action, but what are you really doing in regards of finding out what that platform stands for? Know what their mission, know what their statement. You need to even know what advertising options they have, because you want to actually have more media exposure. Media exposure is powerful. A lot of times you see return on it pretty quickly. Sometimes it may take a while. The thing is, I think, let me just say this, that a lot of people, when they go on interviews, they say, the thing is about you got to be able to give value to the listeners. And how you convert the listeners to customers is what information you give them. And I try to tell guests, I try to tell them that a lot of times people will not buy your book because they don't know you. The key is to get them on, guess what, your email list. And actually, at my master class, we're going to actually talk about how you do that, what needs to be in that, and what not to put in there. Because the key is, if you do a lot of stuff and it's the wrong stuff, the wrong information, that is not valuable at all. You see what I'm saying? So number one should be number two and three as well. Due diligence, because when you send a swipe file, meaning get the information, and they accept you for the interview, that goes right in for number two. Are they gonna send you pre-courses? Are they gonna actually do a freestyle like we tend to do on our platform, meaning that you just flow? And I like that being freestyle because that allows the guests to actually freely talk about the things that they are doing in life. And that's just my opinion. I know a lot of people do preset questions, and I'm happy for them. But the key is, even with the preset questions, if you do that, you need to allow the guest to be able to go from that if they say something very powerful. They say something that you know your audience will take value from. You need to be able to say, let's deviate from the plan that we have of these set questions and be able to have an authentic, a real conversation so the audience can get something out of the conversation. You see what I'm saying? That's the key. Now, a lot of times people don't value your platform. I want to say this at this point, but you have to show that you value your own platform. You need to be respectful, be on time, be able to say what you have to say, and be able to share information that's valuable to the listeners and also valuable to just people in large, because you never know who will actually hear the recording. So number two is when you actually have a guest, you need to inquire about if there's any pre-written questions, or can I send some questions in, or are we doing freestyle? So you may have a hint of what that information is because you've already listened to the pre-shows. You've always listened to previous shows. You've always listened to things that they've done on their platform. So you already kind of maybe know that information. But you have to reach out. First of all, saying thank you for this opportunity, and then go in and ask if there are any questions in regards, are they pre-made questions, or are we going to do just a freestyle? And again, I already have told you that I really, really, really love the freestyle, okay? All right, so that's number one and number two. I want to say this as well. Just a side thing is make sure you have the right bio when you send it in your information. Honestly, people do not want to know what city and state you stay in. They really don't want to know, to be honest, let me be just real. They really don't want to know the names of your children. They want to know how you're going to take care of the pain that they have at hand. So if you are actually a life coach, are you going to say something or give me an exercise that changes my life to better? If you're a financial coach, are you going to say something that I can do that I actually can leave a legacy, that I actually can make more money in the next 3 months, 6 months, a year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years than I have ever projected to make in my life? You see what I'm saying? It's something to it. As being also, being in media, having media exposure, being on your platform, Dr. Sunday, how is that going to help me? That's going to give you media exposure. That's going to give you advertising. That's going to give you marketing. That you're going to be exposed to many people that you may not even know. And it may be people that you actually know as well. But the key is getting the visibility, being seen, being heard, and you know, of course, that leads to getting paid, right? So anyway, let's go on. I do want to mention this, that the masterclass is actually set to come up, and the masterclass will be at least an hour minimal that we talk about the different things of what you need to, more in detail of how to get on podcast, what podcast to contact, what to say when they say yes, what to say when they say no. So what information you need to send them in regards to making it a smooth situation in regards to the host of the podcast. You see what I'm saying? So that's number one, research. Number two is actually ask questions and, of course, say thank you. Thank you. Now, people, you would think in the world that people would know to say thank you, but a lot of people, they don't, and I'm sorry to say that. But please say thank you, because the person you say thank you to actually would probably want to book you again, because you were very respectful, that you actually knew what you were doing, that you actually were very professional and respectful during the interview. Now, the last one I want to talk about is regards to following up. Okay, you've had the interview. So what do you do next? The link that they send you, what do you do with it? You have to always know how to repurpose your information. Are you going to actually break the video up? Is this video blog? Is this actually a radio or a podcast interview? Are you going to take that footage and break it up and actually send it out to your email list or send it out in a full sense? Are you going to share it on social media? You're going to actually, what you going to do with it? Are you going to text the information to other people? The thing that's important is that is valuable content. You sometimes when you do a podcast interview, you may say some things that you've never actually said openly before. You may say some things that someone needs to hear right now. You may say some things that someone needs to hear, guess what, at another opportunity, at another time. So you always, always repurpose. You can actually get it transcribed. You can put it up on YouTube. You can actually blog about it and have the product that you one of the product that's aligned with the radio interview that you had. You can actually put that up and actually drive traffic to your blog and also to your product, and you can do that on Pinterest as well. So use the LinkedIn, all the social media to the best of your knowledge. We don't have to be experts on the platforms, but we need to be able to make sure that we're sharing our intellectual property. So that's number three. The other thing that I want to talk about is, with all of that, we have to know how to do it. How do you do this, Dr. Sunday? How do you actually do your due diligence to find the right podcast? How do you do this, Dr. Sunday, of actually knowing what to say in regards to asking them for an interview question, asking them for the next step? And number three, what do we do with the interview information that we get, the link? If it's a magazine, a write-up, what do we do? All that information will be explained at our masterclass. Our masterclass, you can go to beseenbeheardgetpaid.com. And that's it. You know what it is, www.beseenbeheardgetpaid.com. And you can register if you need more information about a payment plan or something of that sort. Please email us. And you can email us through our website. Go down to the bottom and schedule a session. And we can actually jump on a call to actually talk more about the information. And you, also, you can email my team at Renee, R-E-N-E-E, the at sign, getpurposenow.com. That's Renee, R-E-N-E-E, the at sign, now.com. And we're going to actually do it via Zoom. We will send you the information in regards to tuning in. The replay will be available for 24 to maybe 48 hours because, as you know, business coaches, if you're all here, this is also going to be a pay evergreen project. So after you do this, people will be able to get this information if they leave it throughout the year. That's the way you're supposed to do it. You're supposed to be able to repurpose your information, and that's a whole other conversation that we could talk about at another time. But podcast interviews, there are millions out there, but you need to make sure that you're actually on the right one. Because right now somebody is wondering why they suck. Somebody right now is overwhelmed. Somebody right now wondering why they don't have peace, joy, and happiness. They want to know why they created all these projects and nothing has taken off. They want to know why they paid all these money to these coaches and haven't got the results that they thought they were going to get in the beginning. You need to take advantage of this opportunity so you can learn how to be seen, be heard, get paid on podcasts. This is our podcast masterclass. So you can learn how to be a featured guest and do it that you make it profitable. That's what we have to do, and that's what my story, and I'm going to stick to what I'm saying. But if you want to actually, as of the time of this recording, we're offering complimentary consultations. You can jump on the call for 15 minutes. Go to our website, which is reneesunday.com. That's R-E-N-E-E Sunday, S-U-N-D-A-Y.com to get more information. You can go to www.reneesunday.com and get that information all the way at the bottom. You can schedule a complimentary consultation. But I wanted to come in and talk about that information, the three hacks to have a profitable podcast interview. Just to recap, number one is do your due diligence and research the right podcast to be interviewed on. Number two, are you going to ask questions? You got to ask questions. Are the questions pre-written? Are they going to do freestyle? Or can we send questions in? Because you need to know. But you should know the format of the show because you've done your due diligence before you contacted them. And then the last thing is, what are you going to do with the interview information? After you've gotten this information, how do you repurpose it? There's several ways that you can actually repurpose it, okay? So I just wanted to come in. This is Dr. Renee Sunday, the platform builder, and we wanted to get information to you about that. And I want you to know that you do have a calling. You do have a reason that you were born. We got to do three things. We got to believe, we got to trust, and we got to walk it out. And you got to, you know, don't stop. Get it, right? And what are we getting? We're getting our purpose, and we're getting our purpose what? Now. So the numbers to get in the master class is www.beseenbeheardgetpaid.com. And again, that is beseenbeheardgetpaid.com. And also for a strategy session at the time that we're recording this, that's complimentary, is at reneesunday.com. That's R-E-N-E Sunday, S-U-N-D-A-Y, www.reneesunday.com. And we want you to don't stop what? We want you to get it. And what are you getting? You're getting your purpose and getting your purpose now. This is the Dr. Renee Sunday Show. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.